concluded, and the High Court issued a judgment. We'll give you the judgment that the land belongs to Amnyoro Investments Limited. I am told that they have appealed the judgment. I invite the Honorable Mutuse to apply to be co-joined in the appeal, and then he can argue his case. This is a matter that has been adjudicated by the High Court of Kenya and made a determination. And you want to bring it to the National Assembly. The matter is alive with the Court of Appeal. It is sub judice to even discuss it in Parliament because a determination has been made. Irregular procurement of mosquito nets at a cost of 3.7 billion. I saw a huge headline from the Star newspaper, planted headline. This is the most ridiculous headline I've ever seen. And this is the most I lack a proper word, and I don't want to speak in Kikuyu. I think somebody needs to give me some water. I have seen that allegation. I want to respond as follows. One, there is Andrew Murwa, he has sworn an affidavit with the false allegations. And he had better be very careful. Because he has made a statement on oath. In the affidavit, he says that Deputy President was involved in KEMSA 3.7 billion irregular procurement of malaria nets, either directly or through proxies. Father, Shubika Impex Limited is an international company, the fourth largest manufacturer of mosquito nets in the world. It has done many tenders with KEMSA, with the Global Fund, countries in Africa, in Asia. And there was a tender funded by Global Fund through KEMSA, and it was an international tender for manufacturers. The company owned by my son Christo Kenya Limited are not manufacturers, and they did not participate in any way in the tender. In any way. What happened is that in the year 2014, 8 years before I became deputy president, Shubika Impex Limited appointed Christo Kenya as their local agent, whose work is to do their errands and follow their supplies at the ports of entry. Christo Kenya did not participate in this tender. It was done by Shubika. KEMSA wrote to Shubika and said, your tender was not successful because you had a problem with pagination of your security document. Pagination. Those of you who have done tenders, you number the pages. And if they are not right, you can be disqualified. And therefore, they were told, can you come and collect your bid board, your original bid board? That's what happens. If you participate in a tender and you don't win, you are asked to collect your bid board. And they kept on coming to collect the bid board. It was not available for almost 3 months. And they asked the local agent, that is Christo Kenya Limited, can you follow up on our behalf? We participated in this tender. We did not win. We have a letter asking us to collect the bid board. We are waiting for it because this is money that is tied as our agent in Kenya. Can you follow up? And that is why when my son on behalf of Christo Kenya Limited went to KEMSA trying to follow up. And when it was not working, he brought it to my attention and I made a call to Mr. Andrew Mulwa, asking, my son has been here. There's a little issue about a bid board of an unsuccessful tenderer. Why is it that this is money that is tied? And these are foreigners, these are foreign investors. We don't want to make life difficult for them, please. Why don't you release it to it unless there's a problem? No, he said, no, the matter is under investigation. That is why we cannot release it. The bid board is with the SEC. I said, fine. If the matter is under investigation, so be it. Right alone, the investigation.